Yo, what's happening, Caveman?
Welcome back to CaveTV.
We're back, baby. Today's November 17th, National Butter Day.
Butter?
Butter.
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 Butter. Moving on.
You're watching CaveTV. We're back.
We're grateful.
And we're ready to celebrate this season.
Yo, Sam.
What's up?
What is your favorite part about Thanksgiving?
Oh, it's gotta be the food, man.
But what about the movies?
Well, the only good Thanksgiving movie is Charlie Brown.
That's exactly what's next.
Up next, we got the entire Charlie Brown Thanksgiving special.
Review.
Let's go. The entire
it's
Charlie.
It's a review.
All right, pass it over to Julian.
Thanksgiving, and we decided to watch Charlie Brown Thanksgiving special. My favorite part was when Snoopy was fighting with the chair. So go give it a watch. Sure, you guys go check it out. Happy Thanksgiving.
Brian.
I'm Noah.
I'm Lexi Redding.
What is something that you're grateful for?
I'm grateful for sports. Yeah.
And like, do you do tennis? And...
Yeah, I'm on the tennis team.
I am thankful for opportunities in school because a lot of countries around the world don't have that. So I'm very thankful for that.
I am grateful for this upcoming Thanksgiving because we get to eat a lot. Stuff my belly and get to be around people I'm not usually around.
I'm grateful for my mom because she does a lot for me.
Mom providing for me. Like, it's very hard for parents to provide for their children and for their kids. So the fact that she does that for three of her kids is amazing.
I'm grateful for my mom because she just helps me and my siblings out a ton. So, yeah.
My parents for helping me out with getting my schoolwork done. Well, motivating me to do it, I guess. They don't do it for me, but like.
Yo, Thomas, what are you grateful for?
My family. And girls.
What I'm grateful for, bro?
What?
Music.
For real, bro. I'm waiting on that Mac Miller album to drop.
You gonna go to his concert when it's out?
Yeah, of course. Should be soon.
Right, good luck with that, bro.
What are you talking
We got
about?
Song of the Week. He's dead. Pass it over to Mino for some bangers.
He's dead?
Yeah, for like 5 years now. It's running.
Hey, guys. It's Mino Night. Last week, we put up a poll on Instagram for your Song of the Week. Personally, I would have chosen Chit Chat, but you guys chose Beautiful Day by U2. It's a beautiful. Oh, wait, I forgot to tell you guys. Watch out for our next poll at Be Cave Creative. Back to you guys.
Black Friday, the most infamous shopping holiday in existence. Huge discounts mixed with eager shoppers cracked off Red Bull and coffee. I'm sure you've seen some of the chaos that ensues, or you've been one of the brave souls who's experienced it firsthand. Either way, it's quite a sight to say the least. But why? Why the day after Thanksgiving for all these massive discounts? Well, it's actually got some darker roots than you'd imagine. The first Black Friday wasn't about big sales and good deals, it was about a huge risk that ended in heartbreak. In 1969, two of the wealthiest men in America decided to buy out as much gold as they could. They were hoping to drive the price up and sell the gold for a fat profit. Unfortunately, their plan was revealed, which caused the entire stock market to drop more than 20% in the following week. So, maybe not a great start to this holiday. The day after Thanksgiving would be when retailers sold a ton of holiday merchandise. If they were at a loss for sales that year, aka in the red, this influx of holiday shoppers would send them into a profit for the year, also known as being in the black. Hence the name Black Friday.
You know, I bought a turkey for like $3 yesterday.
Not even Black Friday.
The dealer in the alley said it was.
Okay, well, that's the end of our show.
Wheel of Eddings.
Thomas.
Get in here, bro.
Bro, everyone, say hello to Thomas.
Hi, guys. Welcome to Happy Thanksgiving.
Yep. All right, ready? Spin
that
wheel!
That was a good spin. That was a really good spin. What does that even mean?
I don't know. Okay, so we're just gonna ignore that for now.
What's that? Where are you?
It's good, okay, man.
We're back.
Connor,
Sam,
wake up.
No Friday this week. Let's go,
wake up.
That's Connor. You're watching CaveTV. Today's show. We came in today's like,
we got national highlights.
Welcome back, Caveman. This is CaveTV.
So fine.
Don't be nice to him in the day. Sam, man. Let's keep it moving. We got
Sam.
You're watching CaveTV.
You never know what you got till it's gone, right? Why is that? Why do we let the most important things in life just slide by without giving a second thought? They say ignorance is bliss, the bliss turns melancholy, and we soak in our sorrows of unappreciative living. Expecting more till we have it all, and once we do, we still need more. The repetition of black and white turns life more into a story than it is our lives. Never batting an eye to the sheets on the bed or the reflection that hides faint in a window. That two-dimensional life of scrolling a repetition starts gaining depth and color once we start the art of noticing. Wake up. Look around you. There's more to life than streaks and scrolling, more than likes and comments, more than follower counts and social acceptance. You are you. We are here, and that's important. Open your eyes. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up.
Wake up. Yo, wake up, bro. Dog, you're sleeping on a job, man.
What are you talking about?
That's my bad.
That's my bad. So
bad. Hey, thanks for tuning in. This is Cave TV streaming from our cave to yours.
Follow Cave Creative on Instagram and YouTube.
That's it. Peace out.
See ya.